the last of my unboxing, hopefully, for the pre-order of this mini catalog. I laugh because I can't even count how many unboxings I've done by now. And in this, the agenda here for today is going to be sharing some products from a suite. Okay, let me get this name right, because there's a couple different ones. This is called the Love You Always suite of products. So I'm going to show you the designer series paper. This paper, 1, 2, 3, okay, 3 types of paper from that suite. Love You Always. Then I have Hydrangea Hill. So these are going to be some papers from that suite. Specialty papers. Okay, I have this cactus. Hi, Nancy, Joe. I already forgot the name of this. Cactus something. Flowering Cactus product medley. This is the refill. I don't know if I'll open the entire kit or just the refill, but I definitely want to show you at least the paper. Okay. Then I have these little cards. What are these called? These are called, they're sort of part of the, they all go with the Valentine's theme. Hi, Donna. So they're going to go with, I can't show you the inside of the catalog, so I'm kind of flipping from the pages. These are called Sweet Little Valentine's Cards and More. So we're going to open those. Okay, we're going to open these boxes, which are part of the Love You Always. In fact, we'll start with that because one of my teammates said they're tricky, and I figured let's just do it live, make it kind of fun. And I got some little clips here. And then I have another kit. I'm not even going to get your hopes up on how many kits I'll do, because I have, there's 3 or 4 kits in this catalog. There's a product medley. There's a birthday kit. There's another kit. Anyway, I don't know if I'll get to all the kits. All right, so thank you all for joining me. And what I like to do at the beginning of these, hi Francis, hi Bree, hi Janet, is I like to start each of my unboxings with a follow-up from the last unboxing. In the last unboxing, which that's when my tripod broke and I had some, this is what happened in that one, and my the thing that held my phone broke, and you got to see my ceiling and then my floor, and then the phone crashed. Everything's fine with the phone or the camera. And then anyway, I got a new stand for my phone. And anyway, this is we started making this in one video, stamping the ice cream scoops. And then in the next video, I finished the ice cream cone. And so we used, in the last video in the unboxing, I used this punch here. Okay. This punch is called Ice Cream Cone Builder Punch. We used that. We made this ice cream cone. I showed you this punch here. The double oval punch. I punched out some Oso Ombre paper right there in front of you, and I had the little circle there, and so I left the video, and all I did was put together this card. So this is a follow-up to that. I used Bermuda Bay ink. You saw me make this entire thing, except for the designer series paper part. I took a piece of old olive. I took the paper that was called Ice Cream Corner Designer Series Paper, and that's it. I made the card. It's plain in the inside. It says, "You're so cool." Okay, so you saw how I did this one in Cinnamon Cider, Purple Posy, Terracotta Tile, off stamping on once and then stamping off, making it lighter, Bermuda Bay, stamping it once, stamping it off, some extra sprinkles and old olive, tied together the old olive card with these sort of polka dot paper and the background. So that's a follow-up. So you get to see how easy it is to make cards. And then in the other unboxing before that, I made this card using the new Sand and Sea Suite, and you saw me make that. Okay, and we talked about snail mail. There's lots of great new products. All right, so they're all going to be part of this one. If you would like a catalog, use the link in the description to my Stampin' Up! Store, and then you click on Contact Me. And in the Contact Me, you can put your address, or I'll write you back and ask you for your address. But if you've asked me for a catalog before and you never got one, it's because I wrote you back and you never gave me your address. It has to be U.S. address, too. That could be a reason. And maybe my email went into your spam folder. Who knows? Who knows why? But you can still, I mean, it's not because I was ignoring you. I never emails, no matter how many I get. I try not to. I shouldn't say never say never. I don't do it purposely. Okay, so let's start out with some paper. True Love Designer Series paper. And this is a black and white. So the colors are just black and white. And this is going to be one of the paper that's in my regular paper share, whereas many of the other papers I'm showing you today are going to be part of the deluxe paper share. So I'm having a paper share. The details, again, link in the description of this video, and it shows you all the things included. Now this is pretty cool. This is paper that looks like it'll be really fun to color. But I didn't know this before I opened it. And so therefore I didn't take out my blends. I would have actually brought some blends closer to my camera here so we could have tried to color this paper. See how that will work with the alcohol marker. So that's really nice though. I didn't really know what this was going to look like before I opened it. So every when you get a pack of 12 by 12 designer series paper, it's double-sided. And so there's two patterns. Boy, that's looking really dark. That can be used for anything, that one. Okay, nice. I would just say for this paper that you're going to have to color it to really make it pop. But, I mean, it's not that it won't be good on the background. Maybe some sponging and stuff, but it's just going to be something that would really look better colored, I think. But what's nice when Stampin' Up! Gives us these options, we can make this paper anything we want it to be when it just comes with black and white like that. Hey, this is nice. Some daisies and some stripes. Now, this reminds me of the piece I just made the card with. Let me grab that card again. The piece of Blackberry Bliss, right? I like that diagonal stripe pattern. And lastly, I think this is lastly. Maybe not. No, I think I have a couple more to show you. There's a couple more sheets. Honestly, and you know how I like to keep it real, they're all starting to look the same to me. I don't even know if I showed you this sheet yet. It's like, what is happening with this paper? Did I show you this? Honestly, it's all a bunch of black and white flowers, and I'm all flowered out. But so this is the paper I'm going to be putting in my paper share, but I don't know if I'll be getting any of it because, I mean, I might get some to color, but I'm just like, and I might get some for these plain backgrounds, but when it's that many flowers, I'm like, ah, too much. All right, so that's that. That's called True Love Designer Series Paper. Okay, now let's move along. And the rest, this is also part of the Love You Always Sheet. This is going to be one of my specialty papers that I put in the deluxe paper share. There's so many papers. It's Love You Always Designer Series paper. I couldn't put all the papers into the regular paper share. There's already 120 sheets of 6x6 in that paper share. So all the specialty papers, I did want to include them, so I made it part of the deluxe paper share. I can't send these out until January when I order the paper. I'm only allowed to order right now a very limited amount, so I'll be able to make my sample. And that's it. I'll be showing a sample on YouTube of what the share looks like once I put it together in a week or so. Well, hopefully before the early bird deadline. Oh, this is interesting. It's one-sided. Okay, let's look at the paper and then we'll go over. All right, I didn't know it was going to be one-sided. Okay, it is, but that's because it's nicely foiled. Let's see. Love You Always Specialty Designer Series Paper. Blushing Bride, Rococo Rose, and Sahara Sand. This is interesting. See how many of each one. Okay, good. There's more than one pattern. I'm like, I hope it's not all just one pattern. I'm like, so this would be the Blushing Bride color. I hope you can see that. Okay, that's better. Just because the way my light is. I'm going to try to turn the light so you can see that foiling. I hope the color is doing it justice on the camera. Okay, so you get four. Okay, I'm just counting. I'm just making sure you get four sheets of this, four sheets of Blushing Bride. Okay, four sheets. Now, I like this one. Honestly, the Blushing Bride, I like the foiling, but I like this color better. I like the Rococo Rose better. Okay, so I'm happy with this one. And you know, if I'm not, I'll tell you. So this is good. I like this one. Rococo Rose, four sheets of that. And again, it's single-sided, but it's a specialty paper. Oh, this is good. This is good for jungle patterns and things. So it's Sahara Sand, but look at these cool leaves in there. That's going to just be good for anything you do with nature. Because Sahara Sand's a neutral color. So that's good. Okay, so that's the Love You Always. And there's some more in the Love You Always suite. This is called the Love You Always. Okay, hold on. I have to get the paper. Love You Always Specialty Designer Series Paper. So this is in the deluxe paper share. And you get free shipping when you do both paper shares. Otherwise, the shipping's still only $4. It's really inexpensive. The deluxe The regular paper share is $40 and the deluxe paper share is $30. I'm already. I'll get that information in a little bit. Okay. That's good. So I'm happy with this foil paper. Now let's look at Love You Always Sweet some more. I'm going to look at this one. This is called the Love You Always Foil Sheets. Okay, so I already put this in my share as well. Without even seeing these, I knew what was coming because we were allowed to download a PDF of the catalog early. The demonstrators were. So I already knew what I was going to include in the share before I even got these products. But again, I'm limited in how many I can get. I can't. So the way paper shares work is you order it and I order it. Oh, that's nice. This reminds me of champagne. Our champagne foil. I'm wondering if this isn't champagne foil. Let me. Huh. Yeah, and I'm wondering if this isn't pink rose gold. Let me just look at the catalog real quick and see what these are. Ooh, I'm going to go blinded on that one. All right, so just so I can get this right, you can see my t-shirt and you can see it's a mirror paper. You can see my ceiling. It is very pretty, but it's going to blind us. Let's see. I'll get it off the screen in a second after I tell you what it is. So Love You Always Foil, it says number 3. Blushing Bride Rococo. Nope, that wasn't it. Love You Always Foil Sheets. Yeah, I guess it is. It's the same. It says Love You Always Foil Sheets. That's what these are. Love You Always Foil Sheets. And it's saying Love You Always Foil Sheets are Sahara Sand. I'm very surprised. This does not look like Sahara Sand to me. It says Sahara Sand. I'm going to put these off to the side. And it says Rococo Rose. So, again, that doesn't really, I don't know. Let's compare it to the other one. Okay, this, and then it says Blushing Bride. Well, it goes with the, yeah, I guess it is a shade of Blushing Bride. That's the Blushing Bride. So I guess it does go with that. That's pretty interesting paper. Let's grab the Rococo Rose paper. Yeah, I guess it is Rococo Rose. I mean, that's what it says it is. I mean, they use the right formulas. I know Stampin' Up! Is very into their color formulas and when they get things produced. But to me, when I first opened it, it looked like champagne. But when you put it next to the other color, it does take on that color. Okay, so I'm happy with the foil sheets, and you'll get some foil sheets in the deluxe share. I don't know how many you'll get. Let's see, foil sheets. 6 pieces, meaning you get 2 6x6 squares of those. Okay, I didn't get the stamp set for that. There is a Love Always suite of products, including two different stamp sets, 2 sets of coordinating dies, all kinds of ribbons and embellishments and things. But I did get the boxes. We'll do the boxes before we get into Hydrangea Hill, because this is part of the Love You Always suite. Now, I have a team member, Linda, and she was saying these are tricky. But I did look, I didn't look at how they're put together. I just looked at the picture of one put together all the way. So we're just going to try it. You know, I like, that's the fun of doing live videos. You just try things. So these are the new boxes called Love You Always Treat Boxes. Food safe treat boxes. You get 10 in the pack. Okay, this is the little wrap. This is a wrap for the box. So what's nice is if you want to stamp the lid, or you can stamp the box. That's a little wrap, right? And it's a slider box. I've made slider boxes in the Paper Pumpkin videos recently. Showed you how to make your own slider boxes. What was I going to say about this? Oh, stamp it while it's flat. Don't go doing this and then try to stamp it. Don't try to lower it down later and try to stamp it. Stamp it while it's completely flat. And then you'll be able to use that. Okay, let's try to put this together. Let's see how it goes. Okay, well, actually, I'm familiar with this because of all the box making I do with the scan and cut, so I don't think this is going to be too tricky because we're always making our own boxes and when we work with the scan and cut. So let's see. We will see how this is put together. These are going to probably flap up somehow, something like that. Okay. Okay, here we go, something like that. So you see what I did? I just bent it down. In other words, the bottom looks like it's double lined. That looks like it's going on. And the reason it looks like it's double lined is because all this stuff is going to be hidden. It looks like you're going to hide this flap and hide this flap, right? So That's what it looks like to me from being familiar with how these types of boxes are put together. So I'll do one slower. I'm just trying to get it. I'm getting my bearings, and then I'll do it slower. Because a lot of my team members are on here, other demonstrators. You might need help with this box, and now you'll know. Okay, so what I did is, these are the little flaps I'm going to hide. I'm going to hide the side little flaps. So what I'm doing is just bending along all the score lines so you can hide all your little flaps. Okay, so stick your paper in there. Okay, so you're going to go like that and hide it. I mean, not hide it. You're not hiding it yet. You don't hide it till the final little flap comes down. Yeah. I can see how these are a little tricky. Okay, like that. And then you're going to push this in. Push that one down. And that one goes in. Okay, I did it fast, but that was because I was just making sure I was doing it right. All right, so that works. So now I'll do it a little bit slower and let's see if I have better lighting here. I'm going to turn my light a little bit. All right, so you get your box. Oh, and by the way, and then to finalize it, you're going to do this. You're going to slide it in there. Let's see. Is there an upside down or a right side up? I don't think it really matters. Those are pretty tight, though. Those are pretty tight cover. All right, so good. All right, good. So I figured it out. Now I'm going to try to break it down slower. So, all right, so good. I'm happy with this box. I'm going to be getting a buttload of those boxes because, you know, I do make boxes a lot and I teach people how to make boxes. And the thing, you know, that's great about making them with the scan and cut is you can customize the size of the box. But when you have, for the price we sell our boxes, I mean, when you have something like this great that you can decorate, it's already cut, it's made of cardstock, it's already scored, and the time it saves you, and plus the paper you have to use, I mean, hey, why not? I'm just going to be getting a lot of these. I like this kind of box. And it also looks like it won't get crushed in the shipment. You know, and I do ship a lot of stuff. All right, so here we're going to go. We're going to open this up. And the first thing you do, let's put it on without the background. Okay. First thing you're going to do is fold along all your score lines. Okay. So fold along all your score lines. And then these kind of score lines, you're going to be, you know, bending up that way. Okay, so fold along. Okay, and you're bending that one up too. I guess I would just call this a slider box. Okay? And then you're going to just fold along all the square lines. Now this, when you think about it, this has to hide. This is going to hide everything. It's going to hide your flap. It's going to hide this little flap. It's going to hide that little flap. And it's going to hide this little flap. So knowing that, this has to go in at the end. And you see that? It even snaps. How brilliant is that Stampin' Up? It's going to snap in there at the end and hold everything in there. So just leave that out. So since you know it's going to hide everything, get rid of it. Put it that way. Get rid of it, right? And work with only this. Pretend it's not there right now. And just work with the rest of the box. So you're going to go like this. You're going to push those in like that on the side. And you're going to take these little end flaps and you're going to push them, okay, like that. Push it and you're going to... Push it good. Okay, there's always a song. And then, so that's it. You're holding the sides in, then you're pushing that side down, and now that side will hold these two sides. Okay, well, what I like about this, what's brilliant about Stampin' Up, is you could have had it inside of the box look like that. It would have been cute enough. It would have been fine, right? But knowing that there's this nice flap that's going to hide everything, snap, hear that little snap? Then it, look at that. It looks even more professional. And you got a double-lined box, which makes it really strong. And then you take your little, where'd it go? These things. You take one of these, you stamp it, you make it all pretty. And you just pop it open. And I'm sure there's no up or down for that. It shouldn't matter. And you're going to just slide it in there. So picture a couple things about these boxes. You could die cut. But if you're going to die cut, remember, say you want to put a window for candy. You can't just try, you know, you're not just going to try, you could try to punch, but you got cardstock here, right? So punches are not good for this kind of thing because you have to get all in there and it wouldn't work, right? So you need a metal die, but the trick is you're going to have to put something between. So you can put the metal die there You can cut a window, but then you're going to put a little plate, you know, you're going to put something in there so that this part doesn't cut out. You don't want the window to cut through two holes. So you put the window there, put some stuff in there so it doesn't cut through both sides. And then you can have a little window, for your treat box so you can see inside. I probably won't attempt to make a window with the Scan and Cut because the Scan and Cut will try to think, it'll measure the distance and it'll think this is so tall and it'll cut through both layers and then, but I mean, I might try it. I might be daring and try it. All right, so I'm happy with these little boxes. All right, and let's, while we're on the Valentine's Day theme, we'll just open these little guys and then I'll open Hydrangea Hill. Hydrangea? I don't even know if I'm saying that right. I know you're always laughing at me the way I pronounce things. I'm entertaining, they say, some of my team members, the way I say things. All right, let's see. These are called Sweet Little Valentine's Cards and More. Hydrangeas. Am I saying it right? Melba, Hydrangea, Hydrangea. All right, these are super, super cute. Oh my goodness. I'm excited with glee. Look how adorable. Love you. Oh, and they go with this. I didn't realize it was this. Honestly, you know what I thought I was getting? I didn't know what I was getting. I just got them because I thought I was getting memories and more types of packs. The things that, I don't know why I thought that, but I did. And this is like way, way better than I could have imagined. Because look at these cute little foiled envelopes. Oh my goodness. Thanks, Susan. I'm glad I pronounced it right. Oh, look at these. They're foiled envelopes. This is like a home run. This is like, I had no idea I was getting this. Now it's like I want to get more, but I probably am limited. These are super cute. So you got foil lined envelopes. You got 10 of them. You got really beautiful cards. Now I need to know what the coordinating colors are because I'm excited. These are beautiful with the foil. Okay. I'm paging over here into my catalog that I can't show you on camera. After the catalog launches on January 5th, I will show the catalog. Sweet Little Valentine's. Calypso Coral. Okay. It says Calypso Coral is one of the colors. Melon Mambo. Where the heck's the... Melon Mambo. Okay. It's saying Melon Mambo. Not seeing that. Okay. And Petal Pink and Pool Party. Maybe it's a different shade of it. That's the Petal Pink. That's the Pool Party. That must be the Melon Mambo. I guess it's a really, really dark shade of Melon Mambo. All right. So I'm very happy with these because you can take these little cards. You are loved. Or, oh, that would make a nice little note card. But you can also take them and make an instant little... Beautiful card. I almost wouldn't want to cover that card up, though. I mean, what? It's so beautiful. Who'd want to cover that up? Maybe this one you can cover up the stripes. But still, I mean, you don't need to. You can do other things with these. Like I made an extra ice cream cone. I don't know if it's the right colors. Ooh, it's not bad, though. I made an ice cream cone from the last unboxing. Yeah, look at that. That would make a cute little card, right? You are cool. Of course, I would use the colors inside this. I could put the you are cool on these little note cards. All right, that's what I'm going to do with these. And then I'm going to save these for maybe thank you cards or something. Because these are too nice to cover up, to cover that up with. I might put like little ice cream cone cards. Using the colors that they just said, not they. Calypso Coral, Melon Mambo, Gold, Petal Pink, and Pool Party. So using the colors from these cards. Super happy with these. I mean, they're only going to be $10. And I don't remember, what is there, 10 cards? 10 cards, 10 envelopes, and 10 little doohickums. Okay, so great, great. Okay, now we'll open Hydrangea Hill. Hydrangea Hill. Now this is not my kind of thing because of the flowers, but I love the color. Like I do love, like, I love this kind of brightly colored type of stuff. Right? Like I like this kind of paper and I would get more of this paper. But what I'm saying is, as far as the stamp set, there is a suite and like I heard my team saying, oh, at first we couldn't buy the dies and they were like, I couldn't get Hydrangea Hills dies and I was trying to get them. And it's probably not something I'll get with the Hydrangea Hills dies. I'm going to open those clips later. But I do really like the paper. So again, you get, you know, 12 by 12 sheets when you get our designer series paper. Here, let's put that one on top so you can look at it while I grab the coordinating colors. You have something to look at here. Here's the back of the paper. Gorgeous grape. Okay, there's the gorgeous grape. Let me take this piece off. Highland heather. Okay, that's the lighter purple is Highland heather. And then you got misty moonlight. That's the misty moonlight. Old olive. There's the old olive. Rococo rose. That's this rococo rose, this piece here. Seaside spray. Well, it's probably mixed in with the lighter type of blue. So like that's the misty moonlight and the seaside spray is behind it. And that's it in Whisper White. All right, so that's pretty cool. I do like the colors. I'm liking this. Ooh, I like this color combination. Now this is fun. I can picture Easter cards. I can picture just already cutting this out, having a card front, and then the sky is already there. So that's really nice. And this is cut in half. So this is part of our specialty designer series paper share. But when you might not get the... So since I cut this in 6x6 pieces, you might not get like the whole pattern. You might get like a little piece like that, but that's what it is. It's paper share so you can try things. Oh, wow. Wow. Okay, do you remember we have a card kit? And it just, the name just escaped me. But there's a card kit in the annual catalog and it would totally go with this. The colors and it just reminds me of that purple kit. Purple is not really my thing, but like this is a nice purple. It was my thing. It was my favorite color when I was little. But like, it's this paper is awesome though, growing on me. Like it's really, really popping. It's popping. Popping colors. Oh, see this one. I like this side better. So each paper is double-sided and you can pick which side you like better. But that, I like this kind of pattern better, the watercolor look. And then the bouquet. But there's a lot you can do with this kind of paper. Watercoloring patterns, and that's the Rococo Rose. So really nice, really nice. Hydrangea Hill. Now let's look at the specialty acetate. Let's look at that. Now if you recall, yeah, slimline cards. It would make nice slimline cards with that one piece you're talking about. I bet you're talking about this, Savan. It says for the slimline card. That one piece that has the sky, or not sky, but it looks like the sky. We'll look at that one. Here, we'll put that one there for something to look at while I open the next. Okay, while I open this one. This is called the Hydrangea Hill Mercury Glass Acetate. Now, if you recall, I don't know if you recall, because a lot of you are new to my channel. So, yeah, Gorgeous Posies. Thank you, Susan. That was it. Don't you think that would go good with the Gorgeous Posies kit, with like all these purple... and everything, it would just like really nice. I mean, even the stamps in that kit would work nice with this. Oh, this is interesting. So if you were around for last Christmas season, I put my flashing snowman rings, which I have some more for this Christmas season. I put them into the mercury glass acetate paper. That's a silver paper. It looks just like this. It wasn't this kind of purplish. And you can make little lanterns with the curvy keepsake box. This is pretty cool. So that's what this paper is. And I mean, of course you can use it for card overlays, but you know what? I don't think I ever used my mercury glass acetate for card overlays. I always used it for curvy keepsake boxes because I like it because you can see through the boxes and put those little tea lights, the little battery operated tea lights in there. I'll tell you the colors in a moment. I think it's just Rococo Rose. I mean, I'm not positive. I'm just putting it there so you can see that there's two shades of this. You get four sheets. Right. It's, I don't want to blind you, so let me put a different piece of paper there. Let me flip it over. So that was the mercury glass acetate, and that is, it's saying that there are four sheets of that. It says Hydrangea Hill, mercury glass acetate, Highland Heather. It was Highland Heather and Rococo Rose. And I don't really see much done with it in the samples of the catalog. Yeah. But I've seen samples of the other kinds used as card overlays. All right, so that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. All right, cactus. What time we got? 29 minutes. I'm going to go for the cactus refill instead of the whole cactus. I mean, I'm going to show you this instead of the whole product medley because that way you'll get to see the paper. And that's because of time. Just because of time. But and also because I'll do another video where I show how to make projects with this entire cactus, flowering cactus medley. And then also I want to open these little guys up, the clever clasp. All right, so we have, what's nice about our product medleys now is that you can get refills for them. So what I'm showing you is the refill. A product medley has a stamp set and dies and stickers usually, or felt embellishments in this case. These are pretty cool. We'll pop a couple of these open in a minute. First, let me just see what the paper looks like. And then we'll pop a couple of these on there. Yeah, so the cactus medley, I will open up the whole cactus medley in another video. But I just want to open the paper now because I'm excited and I want to see it. Oh my goodness, how cool is this paper? All right. I don't even know what the coordinating colors are. I have to look at the front of the catalog because our kits are always in the front. Okay, it says Mint Calypso Coral. There's the Calypso Coral. Mint Macron, Highland Heather, Mossy Meadow, Pear Pizzazz, and of course white. So when you get the product medleys, they come 48 sheets in a pack, and you get, so 48 sheets of designer series paper. Okay, so that is the paper. Oh, I like this because you can just punch it out or die cut it out and you have instant cactus because it has already the cactus pattern. So you get 8 sheets of that in the refill or in the medley. I mean, the medley or the refill. Oh, this is interesting. So these would probably go with the dies. I'm pretty sure they do. Oh, that one looks like Mickey Mouse. The Mickey Mouse cactus. This is actually paper, by the way. It's not stickers. It's paper. Pretty cool paper, if you ask me, because you can just die cut out those shapes or cut them out. So that's really nice paper. Okay, here, let's see what this is. Huh. Wow. Super cool. I can see the Mint Macaron and the Pear Pizzazz in this pieces. And there's the other side. Ooh, really nice. This is just gorgeous paper. So that's the other side. Oh, how fun. This will go with just lots of other themes. Like it can go with, you can put that behind other whimsical things like, what are they thinking of? The meerkats, or do they live in the desert though? I'm not sure. I mean, I don't know if they live in that kind of desert, but either way, you could get animals that live in the desert and put that paper behind them. Just so fun. And you could also, when you got small things like that, small patterns, they make little good treat pouches and things. Oh, these are nice, the heart cactus. Looks like a heart. So you get 6 different kinds of 8 sheets of each kind. Oh, that's the Mossy Meadow. Geez, I just love the texture on this paper. Wow. Okay, and then this one is, that's just like it is. That's just the way it is. And then there's some twine. Okay, and then there's a little, let's pop open a couple of these felt things and see what's in them here. Pop in these. Okay, some hearts. Okay, all little hand-sewn elements. These look like just little elements. Just fun, 3D, making things 3D. Little nature elements. And I guess these are going to be the same. We'll try them. So the difference between the refill and the medley is you just don't get the stamps. And there's stamps and dies, which I'll show you soon. That's the difference. You know, you get in the refill, you get more twine. You get more these embellishments. So, yeah, these are cute. Those are cute embellishments. All right, let's open up these little guys. Yeah, this is the Flowering Cactus product medley. The Flowering Cactus product medley. And I have the whole medley to show you, but just because of time and I have so many more kits. I'm going to show you a kit that's already open, but this is the whole kit. I figured I'd open this as part of, I'll open this in another video when I show how to make things from the kit. Then I can open this. I like to see how many things I can make from one kit. It's just kind of a fun thing I started last year in my kit series. I just tried to see how many, I open up a kit and see how many things I can make with one set of paper. Well, I never did finish all the sets of paper. Like when I tried this with botanical something or other, botanical printed or something, botanical prints, I never made it through the 48 sheets of paper, but I make it through all my embellishments. I'd like to see if I can make it through all the embellishments and see how much I can make with one kit. So that's the flowering cactus kit. All right, so where was I? I was gonna open these little clasps. These are called Clever Clasp. These are just in the new mini catalog. And whenever I see new cute things like this, I like to try them out. So we will just see how much they hold. Let's try it. Okay, these two are stuck together. So we have gold and silver. Let's see how many papers we can put in there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Nope, that's 6, 7. There should be 8, but anyway, there's 7 pieces there. Let's just put 7 pieces and see how it holds it. Oh, really strong, really strong. These are super strong clasp. So, and it holds 7 pieces. I'm sure it'll hold more than that, but I was just letting you know it holds at least 7. Okay, let's put it on the felt and see how that holds. So you can hold, you know, when I made those little calendars, in fact, I'll go grab one. It's see, that's pretty cool. Let me grab my little calendar. I made, this is also part of the new catalog, this Dandy Garden Suite. And see, I was using these clips. Now these are retired. These are called mini binder clips. So now you can take the calendar template I showed, and it's all freely available. I gave the template, the whole tutorial on how to do it, and you can use these instead. And I think you would only need one of these because they're so strong compared to those. And they also hold more paper. So you don't have to worry about printing on the cardstock. You could actually hold your whole calendar on cardstock. This one was cut with regular paper. Anyway, that's one use of those. I was thinking of that when I saw those, that they'd be good for mini calendars, but just to hold little, any kind of embellishments on there. All right, so then I will show you something else in our mini catalog. And I did show this in my, I had a different pre-order. I was able to open this kit. It's called You Are the Amazing. It's part of our 2021 January to June mini catalog. But when I attended an event recently, they let me do a pre-order, and I was able to get this stamp set and this kit. So this one's already open, so that's why I figured I'd show you this one, because it's already open. You Are Amazing project kit. And I did get another one of these because I love it so much. I absolutely love the colors of this, and I absolutely love this box. I love the box. See? The nice lid. I mean, I think this is going to be great for workshops. If anybody says they'll host a workshop for me, like anybody locally, I'm going to say, let's do this kit. This is the kit we'll do, because it looks like so easy and so nice. So project kits are really nice. You get a stamp set separately, but then you can keep buying the kit. So you get one, you get the stamp set once. You don't even have to use this stamp. You can use any stamps. This one's called Cling stamp set. You get that once, and then you can just keep getting the project kit, and you can make your 16 cards? Yeah, 16 printed cards, 16 envelopes. And then here's what you make with it. But of course, I'll do a video where I make all kinds of other stuff, I'm sure. That's going to be my project for next year. Next year is going to be, I'll show all the card kits in the series and all the project kits, and I'll make things from them and just see what kind of things we can come up with that are alternatives. But look at this. You get vellum. You get these vellum flags and things, vellum cutouts and cardstock cutouts. Gorgeous. These are Bermuda Bay color. If you ever want to know the coordinating colors in a kit, it's always in the instructions. So right here, somewhere here. Additional products needed. This just tells you what colors, suggested colors you need to go along with it. This is Bermuda Bay, Flirty Flamingo, Gold, Granny Apple Green, Mango Melody, Pretty Peacock, and White. So this is Pretty Peacock. No, this is Pretty Peacock. That one's, yeah, this is Pretty Peacock. And then you get these little stars. I mean, look at all this extra stuff you have to work with. See, I like going, if someone says like, oh, would you want to go to dinner? We're celebrating someone's birthday, right? And I'm like, oh, right now? Yeah, meet you in an hour. This is what you do. You grab a kit. Not that we can go sit down in any restaurants right now. That's another story, only outside. But I'm saying, you know, when you get invited somewhere. Or if you just say, oh my gosh, I forgot so-and-so's birthday. I need to mail them something. And you grab a kit. Kits are great for that. And you can just layer up things and make elegant cards with these kits. So these are your cards. And of course, these make box lids and everything else, not just cards, right? You can turn all these into boxes if you want. Let's see if that one had stripes on both sides. No, solid on one side. Okay, so flowers. Now these are plain. So So I would definitely use these for the background of the cards because they're plain. They need to be decorated. Oh, this is really nice. The foiled ones. And then let's see what the envelopes look like. I already forgot. I opened these a while back. I think they're all the same. Nope, they're not all the same. You have different colors in the lining of the envelopes. So that's that kit called the You Are the Amazing Project Kit. And that I showed you the cactus kit had twine, and this kit has twine. This twine here would be the Granny Apple Green twine to go along with these. And that's where you'd make your little, you know, it shows you where to tie it and everything. It tells you what to do, and it tells you what you need in addition to that. Now, if you already have a lot of inks and other stamps, and you don't have to, you can just get this kit and make your 16 cards, and you don't have to use these stamps. But look how well they go together. Look how well these sentiments from this Your Amazing stamp set go with that kit. Okay, and there's yet another kit in this catalog. So we have a product medley. We have the birthday project kit. A project kit is when the stamp set comes early. We have the all-inclusive Hello Dear Friend kit, which I don't have time to open, but that's an all-inclusive kit. Means it comes with stamps and a block and everything and all the ink you need and everything else. All right, so my camera's already starting to droop. I'm starting to droop. So I'm going to just tell you about my paper share, and then we'll be done. And then I'll do a paper share sample. So this is exciting, this new catalog. Every time we have a new catalog launch, I like to do a paper share. I have two versions. Blah, blah, blah. Don't worry about all that. Just know that you get 120 sheets of 6x6 paper, and you get 12 kinds. And the early bird special by December 20th gets the extra 12 pieces of designer series paper that's not included here. So it could be retired, it could be current, it probably won't be Christmas, but it could be Christmas. I mean, but if it's Christmas, I'll give you more than 12. I'll probably still give you more than 12, but that's beside the point. It's going to be sampler of different kinds of papers that's not included here. And if you're an early bird, because it helps me plan. So that's $40. And then the other option is my deluxe one, that's $30. That's an addition. I have a deluxe paper share. My printer got messed up, but it's $30, and you get 51 pieces. And there's the QR code, meaning you could type out my website. This isn't the same as the website. It's in the description of this video, but this isn't the same as the Stampin' Up! Shop. This is my personal website where you register for this. I'm going to zoom in because you register at thepaperchef.com because that's where I every time I get four participants in both either the deluxe or the regular, I'm able to get a whole set. I order a whole set of paper, like all these papers, and some of them are celebration items, so I might have to get a certain amount of my order to get the celebration items. But anyway, I get a whole set of paper, and then I get it, and I cut it up, and I mail it out. And it's a major production, and I do it I'm signing up now, but I also do it during the month of January, at least the beginning of January I'll do it, until I get burnout from paper shares, and then I'll stop. And that'll be it until the summer when the new catalog comes out. I'll do it again. Sorry, my camera's drooping. Now I'm holding it. It doesn't hold this weight very long. I don't know why it is. But anyway, thank you for watching. This is The Paper Chef, and I hope you enjoyed our new products and you're excited about seeing them. If you like a catalog, then you can start drooling over it. And these products that I'm showing you, most of them will be released on January 5th. That's all for now. This is The Paper Chef.